All right, so we have some pretty big Pac-12 news as former Colorado starting quarterback Sam Noyer unexpectedly entered the transfer portal a couple days ago and has now already found his new home as he will be joining Jonathan Smith's squad at Oregon State. Noyer had a pretty decent year last year, and while his stats may not show it, he had a huge impact on the Colorado program and led them to a great start. They are one game away from the Pac-12 championship, and many expected him to be the guy going into 2021. Well, he has now switched, and he'll be an Oregon State Beaver, and this changes everything for the Oregon State program, and Jonathan Smith will have a huge decision to make. So, before I give out any more information, let's talk about what this means. So in today's video, we're going to talk about what this means, who Sam Noyer is, and why this will create chaos in Corvallis. Now, let's get started. So before we can talk about what this means to Oregon State, we need to know who Sam Noyer even is. He grew up in Beaverton, Oregon, which is actually a suburb to the big city of Portland. He absolutely loved football, and while he was at Beaverton High School, he became a pretty big name. He was the fourth best player in the state of Oregon in 2016, and he had thrown for nearly 2,700 yards and 18 touchdowns during his junior year. Going into his senior year of high school, he really had three schools that were recruiting him pretty hard. He only had three big offers. That included Colorado, Wyoming, and Eastern Washington. And I know what you're thinking, Scott, those are not very big offers. Well, in case you don't know about recruiting, the earlier a player commits, the less big time offers they will get, and typically they will not be ranked as high. Not sure why it happens that way, but once a player commits, scouts and other schools kind of forget about him. After taking a visit to Boulder, he decided to commit to the Buffaloes, who at the time were under head coach Mike McIntyre. He said no school had recruited him harder than Colorado, and he was very excited to become a Buffalo. According to 24/7 Sports, Noyer was a three-star recruit, the number 22 dual-threat quarterback, and the 756th best player in the class of 2016. He came into the Colorado program with Sifo Lufau becoming the star quarterback for the team as a senior, and he would actually lead the Buffs to a miracle 2016 season in which they would go to the Pac-12 championship game and have one of the more memorable years in school history. I actually made a documentary about that a couple weeks ago, so be sure to check that out, as I will leave a link in the comment section. After Lufau was gone, it was going to be him and Steven Montez for the starting job. Montez showed a lot of flash in his time as a freshman in 2016, so he would later get the starting job, and he would start until the 2019 season was over. Noyer was discouraged and actually thought about transferring, but eventually he would stick with his commitment, and he was a guy who worked hard, so he moved to the safety position during the 2019 season. He was a fighter and a great player for the team, and once again, he almost transferred going into the 2020 season. After Mel Tucker had left, Carl Durrell had come in and told Noyer to try out at the quarterback spot. He ended up winning the job and got his chance as a senior to start. Last year at the Buffaloes, he threw for nearly 300 yards and a touchdown in their win over UCLA, two touchdowns and a win over Stanford, and a touchdown in their win over San Diego State. He would have a pretty solid game against Utah, but they would lose a pivotal game to the Utes 38-21, and then Noyer would play terrible in their bowl game against Texas, where Casey Thompson looked like the best quarterback to ever play. Going into 2021, Noyer was expected to start one more year for the program, and just a couple weeks ago, he said, quote, he was ready to compete again. He was one of those super seniors, and he was definitely going to be the starter this fall. He had this to say to the Colorado fanbase when he left. Quote, from an 18-year-old kid to a 23-year-old adult, I have learned so much from this city, this institution, and most importantly, this football program. I have met lifelong friends and made memories that I will cherish forever, and it was truly an honor to wear Colorado across my chest. Thank you to everyone involved in my career at CU, on the field, in the community, and academically. With that being said, I'm excited for what God has in store for my future in this game. Once a Buff, grateful for it all. He had a shoulder injury at the end of last year, and he said he loved his time at Colorado, but he did allude that he wanted a fresh start and a place who needed a veteran quarterback. What I don't understand is he was going to be the starter for Colorado this year more than likely, and he was comfortable in the system, so him leaving only gives him a greater chance of not starting. Well, he finally announced today that he would spend his final season of college with the Oregon State Beavers. The second team all Pac-12 selection will bring experience to the table and will really challenge the incumbent starter in Tristan Jebbia. With him deciding to transfer here, that lets me know that Jebbia's job is not safe or that Jonathan Smith thinks he can get more out of him. In case you don't know who Jebbia is, he was a four-star recruit and actually originally chose to take his talents to Nebraska, but he would then transfer to Oregon State. But then he would transfer to Oregon State with former top 50 recruit Tyjon Lindsey, who's a wide receiver, and both of them have gotten big roles so far for the Beavers. Last year, Jebbia looked good at times and also looked bad at times, and the highlight of the season came when they had an upset win over Oregon. In my opinion, Jebbia is the best quarterback on the roster, but Neuer does have some starting experience, and I could see him pushing him for the job. To be honest, there must be something I don't know, because this does not make a lot of sense. There isn't a whole lot of talented depth behind Jebbia, so I do believe that Neuer is either coming in to be a backup, or just pushed him for the starting job. For both schools, this means there will likely be a starting quarterback battle. As for Oregon State, it'll obviously come down to Jebbia and Neuer. And then at Colorado, it gets really interesting as they have Tennessee transfer JT Schrout, redshirt freshman Brendan Lewis, and true freshman Drew Carter for that spot. And I'm a little bit worried about the Buffaloes going into 2021, as that quarterback room is not very strong, as Schrout was a guy who basically never stepped foot on the field for Tennessee, and it's not like the Volunteers were winning SEC championships. The one thing that does give Neuer a fighting chance is the fact that Jebbia is recovering from an injury, and maybe he could start the season. The Oregon State Beavers will open up on the road against the Purdue Boilermakers, and as most of you guys know, I went there for 2 years, so more than likely, Neuer's gonna have the game of his life and help them beat my Boilermakers. What do you guys think though? If you're an Oregon State or a Colorado fan, please be sure to let me know your thoughts down in the comment section. Who will win the starting job for both schools, and what this means? Before you go, be sure to subscribe, hit that like button if you want to support today's video, leave another topic I can do next, and check out all my other videos on the end screen, including my video about the miracle 2016 Colorado football season. I hope to see you guys again soon, but until next time, peace.